Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi
Assalamualaikum
wabarakatuh.
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. We are from group one. I am Miss Identika as the moderator and presenter one. And also my friend Ria Saputri as the presenter two will present our material about an error analysis of student narrative text in using simple past. Okay, next. Definisi dari error. A technical error usually doesn't know where the error is. Definisi error. A technical error usually doesn't know where the error is, yaitu suatu kesalahan teknis yang biasanya tidak tahu di mana letak kesalahannya. A coding delay has definisi is state that teacher who have come to realize that making attempts are inevitable part of learning. It is almost impossible for someone learn a language without committing any error. Yaitu menyatakan guru yang telah menyadari bahwa membuat melawan adalah bagian yang tak terelakkan dari pembelajaran. Jadi, hampir tidak mungkin karena seseorang yang si pembelajar bahasa tanpa melakukan kesalahan. Next slide. Next slide, please, Ria. Okay, I will be continue. Definisi error. A technical error usually doesn't know where the error is. Yaitu kesalahan suatu teknis yang biasanya tidak tahu di mana letak kesalahannya. A coding delay has definisi is step that teacher who have come to realize that making against are inevitable part of learning. It is almost impossible for someone learn a language without committing an error. Yaitu menyatakan guru yang telah menyadari bahwa membuat melawan adalah bagian yang tak terelakkan dari pembelajaran. Jadi hampir tidak mungkin karena seseorang yang belajar bahasa tanpa melakukan kesalahan. Next slide, please. Error analysis, definisi dari error analysis. The definition of error analysis, according James in his book, error analysis is the process of determining the incidence, nature, causes, and consequence of unsuccessful language. Jadi suatu proses yang menentukan kejadian, sifat, penyebab, dan konsekuensi dari bahasa yang tidak berhasil. Ada lagi menurut Gus and Slinker, error analysis is type of linguistic that focus on the error learner, make the producing the target language and the target language from itself. Jadi jenis linguistik yang berfokus pada kesalahan yang dibuat oleh si pembelajar dalam menghasilkan target bahasa dan bahasa sasaran membentuk dirinya sendiri. Menurut Brown, definisi error analysis as study of learner error which is based on the fact that learners do make error and that this error can be or analyzed and classified to reveal the system operation within learners. Jadi menurut Brown, analisis kesalahan sebagai studi kesalahan yang didasarkan pada fakta bahwa peserta didik itu melakukan kesalahan. Next slide. Menurut dari mereka, ada dua tujuan utama dalam analisis kesalahan, yaitu it provides data from which inference about the nature of language learning process can be made, yaitu menyediakan dari mana kesimpulan tentang sifat proses pembelajaran bahasa dapat dibuat. Yang kedua, it indicates to teacher and curriculum developer which part of the target language student have most difficulty producing correctly and which error type detract most from learner ability to communicate effectively. Next slide, please. Jenis error itu ada 4 categorize, yaitu ada omission, addition, misformation, and misordering. Next slide, please. The coding delay explain that this error type explain and how the surface structure change that is possible for language learner to omit and disrupt sentence item that create or maybe that maybe they add and scary sentence item in the sentence. The omission error are characteristic by absence of item that must appear in will form, utterance, although any morpheme or word in sentence is potential condition for omission. Some types or morpheme are omit more than others. Yaitu jenis kesalahan bagaimana struktur permukaan itu berubah. Dan si pembelajar bahasa bisa saja menghilangkan atau menambahkan item kalimat yang seharusnya tidak perlu dimasukkan dalam kalimat. Jadi omission itu kelalaian. Yang biasanya menghilangkan suatu kata atau kalimat. Contohnya, we will take our exam, so we write, we will have taken our exam. Next slide, please. Addition. Addition error are the opposite of omission. They are characterized by presence of an item which must not appear and will form utterance. Jadi addition ini biasanya menggunakan bahasa yang berlebihan atau penambahan suatu kata atau kalimat. Contohnya, the fishes has not lived in the oil. Yang benarnya, the fish has not lived in the oil. Okay. The next material will be delivered by Ria Saputri. Ria Saputri, time is yours.
Okay, the next material is a misformation. Misformation error are categorized by the use of the wrong form of morphemes or structure. While in omission, error happen unconsciously. On the other hand, misformation error happen consciously. The students buy something, although it is incorrect. Misinformation is word placement error. For example, it is an pencil. The sentence should be, it is a pencil. The next is misordering. Misordering is a wrong placement of morpheme or a group of morphemes in an utterance. For example, I don't know what that is. Tenses. Tenses are used to show the relation between the action or state described by the verb and the time, which is reflected in the form of the verb. There are two basic tenses in English, the present tense and Example, Jennifer has been watching too much television lately. And then tenses past perfect continuous. Example is Dina has been sleeping for 2 hours before his mother wake her up. And then tenses future perfect continuous is we will have been waiting long. Simple past tense. Definition of simple past tense. Azar 1942 in her book English Fundamental Grammar that the simple past is used to talk about activities or situation that began and end in the past. Yesterday, last night, 2 days ago, and in 1919. For example, the first I studied English last night, and then she visited me 2 days ago. And the last example, my sister was born in 1919. And the last material is narrative text. Definition of narrative text. Narrative is a story. Narrative text is a writing that talks about events. Something happens over a period of time. And then I read friend go to Bandung, type error, misformation, and correct sentence. My friend go, type of error is misformation, and I went. Incorrect sentence. I prayed. In correspondence, I bus. Type of error, misformation, and correct sentence, I went by bus. In correct sentence, I and my type of error, misformation, and correct sentence, I and my friend came. And then, incorrect sentence, go to Plaza Parahyangan, type of error, misformation, and correct sentence, went to Plaza Parahyangan. And then, incorrect sentence, after runs, error, omission, and correct sentence, after having runs. Incorrect sentence, we go to bus, type of error, misformation, and correct sentence, We went by bus. And then incorrect sentence. Buying a drink, type of error, misformation, incorrect sentence, book a drink. Incorrect sentence and playing, type of error, commission, incorrect sentence, and void. Incorrect sentence, we go to home, type of error, misformation, incorrect sentence, we back to home. Incorrect sentence, playing, type of error, omission, and correct sentence, and void. Incorrect sentence, I was preparing, type of error, misformation, and correct sentence, I was prepared. Incorrect sentence, I went to bath, type of error, omission and correct sentence, I take and then sleeping, type of error, misformation and correct sentence, and then sleep. Incorrect sentence, having a lunch, type of error, petition and correct sentence, having lunch. Incorrect sentence, I enjoy, type of error, omission and correct sentence, I enjoy. Maybe enough for me. Back to moderator.
Baik, ya, thank you. Kami akan buka sesi tanya-jawab. Any question, guys? Mm-hmm.